The Philippines' health chief claims the country has now contained the threat of COVID-19. Secretary Francisco Duque III says daily cases did not see a spike despite mass gatherings during the election campaign season. But Duque still urges the public to remain cautious as the virus may further mutate.
Given our measures, our interventions, mukhang contained na siya, no? And the data will support that claim. But at the same time, we are realistic to accept the fact that this virus is notorious for mutations. It is capable of springing surprises at every turn.
Duque, meanwhile, rejected calls to shut borders amid the monkeypox threat. But he adds he has ordered strict monitoring and surveillance for the virus.
It is premature to be closing borders to travelers from these endemic areas. Ang utos ko last May 7 sa BOQ is to be very strict, to enforce strict screening standards, symptom screening. No? Galing sa mga endemic countries or non-endemic countries with risk of monkeypox, dapat alamin yung symptoms.
The epidemic threshold for dengue already exceeded in three Philippine provinces. These are Cagayan, Isabela, and Nueva Vizcaya. A local health official says the number of dengue cases in the whole of Region 2 increased by more than 800% during the early part of this year from the same period in 2021. He cites increased mobility and the rainy season as the primary factors for the outbreak.
Nakalimutan na natin po yung nag-search and destroy ng AIDS breeding places natin. Mm-hmm. Kasi nakatuon na tayo sa COVID lang tayo nakatuon.
We have already coordinated with the different SBUs to start their 4S strategies. Yung 4S strategies po is some search and destroy operations of AIDS breeding areas. Mm-hmm. Then yung second S is seek early consultation. When you have the signs and symptoms of fever, headache, body pain, abdominal pain, vomiting, then self-protective clothing.
The Philippine Health Department.
It has given its regional offices additional funds to cope with the spike in dengue cases. Motorists again call on the Philippine government to suspend the excise tax on fuel as oil prices continue to rise. More from Avenel Chico.
As fuel prices rose, worker Junel has started to use his bicycle and decided to temporarily retire his motorcycle to minimize expenses.
Standby muna sa bahay kasi mahal yung gasolina ngayon eh. Mahirap yung buhay. Nung dati kasi magkano lang yun, nasa 50 lang yun eh, 53. Ngayon, kuwan na, tumaas na ngayon. Magkano na ngayon ng 78 na ngayon. Mahirap ang buhay.
Gasoline now retails at 74 to 97 pesos per liter, while diesel is at 75 pesos to 90 pesos in Metro Manila. Bayan patrollers have also sent fuel prices in their areas where fuel now costs more than 80 pesos per liter. In Palawan, prices are now more than 90 pesos per liter. Motorists are asking the government to consider suspending the excise tax on petroleum.
Sana iano nila yung excise tax ng petrolyo para kahit papaano matulungan yung mga katulad naming motorista.
Kung makakatulong sa pangkalahatan, eh, okay lang po.
Mas okay po yung tanggalin muna yung tax para habang wala pa, at least mababa yung konsumo ng namin.
Removing excise tax means a slash of 10 pesos per liter for gasoline, 6 pesos for diesel, and 5 pesos for kerosene. If government decides to suspend the biofuels component of fuel, gasoline will be cheaper by 3 to 4 pesos per liter and diesel by 1 to 2 pesos per liter. But incoming Senate Ways and Means Committee Chairman Sherwin Gatchalian says it is better to increase the targeted help to the transport sector.
Kahit doblehin pa natin yan to about 6 billion, mas mura pa rin siya kaysa mawala yung 200 billion plus. No? So para sa akin, yan ang mas epesyente pa. Pero hindi ko rin sinasara yung isip ko sa pagtatanggal ng excise tax, Alvin, lalo na kung humaba itong gera.
Gatchalian is not in favor of raising income tax but is studying the possibility of raising taxes on non-essential goods and services. The senator says the BIR should resolve collection efficiency issues, but when asked if the tax bureau should collect the tax on the Marcos estate, Gatchalian insists the issue is political.
Political ploy nga yun, yung narrative na yun eh, no? Lumabas lang ng politika and obviously politika story ang politika at pangpolitika lang yun. Makikita ho natin lumabas pa yan sa mga katunggaling kandidato, no? At kung mayroong ganyan nga, dapat lumabas sa bibig ng BIR yan, lumabas sa bibig ng DOF.
Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez earlier said the government is bent on collecting any tax due on the Marcos estate. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.